We are Casey and Savannah, and we've been best friends for 10 years.
Give Nation a look at
them. They're like a printed, you can see the mountains actually.
Over the years, we have been on many adventures, including plenty of travel, hiking the John Muir Trail, starting multiple businesses, building out a camper van, and creating a little homestead in the city. You even may have seen one of our mini DIY stock tank pool videos. We recently bought 5 acres of raw land in the Upper Cumberland area of Tennessee and are embarking on our biggest adventure yet. Follow along as we build our off-grid homestead from the ground up. Everyone, today we are going to be building a hoop coop on wheels. If you watched our video last week, you will know that we got chicks. A few months ago, we ordered chicks to come at the end of July. We ended up having to postpone that just because of my ankle and a few things, but they finally came, and those are actually going to be raised for meat. If you've watched along our whole journey, you would know that that is actually a big reason why we moved out to our land, just to be able to have control over the meat that we're eating a little better. In the city, you just don't have the space to do that. So this is kind of like one little dream coming true, and we're really excited about it. If you have any questions about why we're doing meat chicks or why we want to produce our own meat, just leave a comment below and we will definitely try to answer your questions. Please be civil. If you didn't watch our video last week, I'll go ahead and link that here. Other than all that, we're gonna go ahead and get started. We've got to kind of round up all of our supplies. We are actually gonna be able to use a lot of the things that we already have on the land. So that's why we're doing what we're doing.
So we've built the frame and Savannah's finishing adding the 4 wheels. So if you notice, we put like a hardware cloth skirting, if you will. One thing I never see addressed with any chicken coop build, or I should say chicken tractor build, is that unless you have perfectly level ground all over your property, which we most certainly do not, there's going to be a gap between the frame of your trailer, and if the ground isn't level, there'll be like gaps in some areas. I've just seen that some people say they'll just like plug it with bricks or put logs or something in those holes, but I just didn't love that idea because I just thought that would, you know, if you're moving the tractor every day, you could spend a lot of time having to plug those holes up. So I saw that someone put a skirting on theirs, and then that way I could just weight it down on the corners, and then that should take care of that. You could, for really extra security, put those like ground staples in, But I think it'll be fine if I just put, you know, some heavy bricks. Our ground is really unlevel. And we did the four wheels instead of two wheels, which is a lot of what a lot of people do, because we actually thought it might make it easier to maneuver. A little concerned about what's going to happen, but we'll have to find out, won't we? So this is what the bottom frame looks like. You know, this is just for extra support. These nuts don't fit on very well, but it's not going to come off, so we may replace those later. But this is kind of what the inside looks like right now. So, Savannah is using this strapping and cutting strips, and then using, you have the screws?
I'm using these self-drilling screws, but these are way bigger than I thought they would be. They're just really fat. They work, but it came in a pack of 25, and honestly, there's just like skinnier ones out there that I probably would use, like roofing screws or something, but this is what we have, so. We're going to use that. And they're good because you don't have to pre-drill or anything. And they already have like, kind of like a washer type head so that they don't sink through the strapping. It just kind of grabs the strapping when you screw it in.
So that's what it looks like. You know, you just need something to attach the cattle panel to the wood. And we're doing it on the outside of the frame because that is gonna prevent it, you know, there's not gonna be room inside there.
We're also going to put a piece of wood, like a little piece of wood, over the cattle panels from the outside, like screw that in so it is sandwiched, so it won't just be held by these straps, although it would probably be fine, but that's just gonna make it more sturdy.
She's talking about like putting another piece of wood out here. So when we saw this hoop coop design, we just were like, that's gonna be so much easier to do. The Joel Salatin coop is much smaller. It's just barely tall enough for like the chicken to stand up in. And then there's the John Suskovich tractor, chicken tractor, which he sells plants for. It just was a lot of work. You have to bend metal. So that's kind of our thought process. This is sort of like a conglomeration of several different tractors that we've seen. TBD if we like it. Our coop size is an 8x8. We chose that because we had 8 foot long pieces. And you'll notice like we have 2x6s on one side and 2x4s on the other. We had planned on having 2x6s all across, and we had 4 2x6 boards, but two of them were 4 inches shorter than actually 8 feet. So that's why. Savannah's just zip tie in this connection. We have these metal clamps that we thought we could use, but they're not going to work out.
That zip tie just broke.
But we'll zip tie just where those two overlap.
What's wrong with these? These are crappy.
It appears we have crappy zip ties though, so I'm not really sure.
So this little framing thing, we watched Living Traditions video on their hoop coop, and that is where we learned how to do that. And this wheel structure thing, I saw the Seasonal Homestead do that on their chicken tractors. So as Casey said, this is definitely a lot of different people's chicken tractors and coops kind of coming together to suit our needs and also use up the supplies we already had. Thank you.
Well, good morning. Day two of our chicken tractor build. Right now, Savannah is putting on J-clips. They specifically say they're like for rabbit cage building or something, or any kind of cage building, but they're, as you see, they're just like little metal clamps that are just gonna like securely attach the hardware cloth to the cattle panels. You know, a lot of people will use chicken, or they'll put like hardware cloth on the bottom and then chicken wire on the top, but raccoons can rip chicken wire to part like a piece of paper. So we were just like, I'm gonna do hardware cloth all over the whole thing. It is more expensive, but it's just kind of easy this way too. So just to do one big sheet over, and then it's like do you remember how big the inches are? I think it's half.
It's a fourth inch.
The fourth inch. So you can use a half inch.
I think it's half inch. That's fourth inch.
Yes, down there. Yeah, the bottom we had a little bit of leftover fourth inch hole, so it is half inch, and that's pretty predator proof. As long as you secure it appropriately. What are you working on now?
I'm working on building the door with wood. Oh, door. This might be too little. That we already have here, but it's not working out.
Problematic.
Just yet.
We will have a day three of coop making or tractor making because we ran out of hardware cloth. So we're just doing everything we can. I have been keeping a record of how long this is taking us. So just cause I don't know, when you see people do stuff and it's all sped up and you know, it's just good to know like, oh, this is gonna take me 10 hours. This is gonna take me 4 days or whatever. So anyway, we will see.
We went into town today to get the stuff to finish the chicken coop, which I guess all we really needed was a little more hardware cloth. But since we went into town, we had to do a lot of other things because going to town is like 45 minutes away. So we've just got back. The sun is going to set in like an hour. So we're going to try to knock out getting this coop done because it's supposed to rain tomorrow. So this is kind of like our last effort to get everything done. We should be able to, but you just never know. There's always something that comes up.
Just another Thursday night, day clipping.
Let's waste Texas on fire.
As you can tell, we did not finish the tractor last night. We did work last night until we basically couldn't see anymore, which, you know, wasn't that long. We did get all the hardware cloth on, so the whole thing is covered in hardware cloth, and the door is covered in hardware cloth, so all that's left to do is we have to cut a bunch of the zip ties off because we ended up using zip ties in a lot of places that the J-clips would not actually clamp down on. I've got to hang the door. We've got to put the tarp on, and then we've got to strap the tarp down. And then I've got one more piece to put on the outside to just kind of secure everything down. We also need to change the hex nuts on the bolts that are in the wheels. I actually got some of those while we were in town so we could change those out and make sure that the wheels don't actually fall off when we're moving it. I'm gonna have to be doing it myself right now because Casey's inside writing our newsletter. When she's done, she'll be out here to help. But I'm just gonna go ahead and get started while it's not raining because there is a chance of rain and we do not want this to not be done today.
When the morning's standing at your door.
Savannah came up with a great name. She said it looks like a chuck wagon, and we needed to call it the chick wagon. So from here on out, ladies and gentlemen, our chick wagon. Let me show you. So she's just nailed down some strapping. We have this on here. There's a piece in the middle, but you can't see it. There's two on the ends. So I was questioning why we had to put all of that on there, because it seemed like the tarp was attached well enough, but she so kindly told me that people who have made these much more than we have suggest putting it on there because wind will get under these flaps and then it can start, ripping it off because they're just attached.
It's more on this side.
Yeah, it's more
folded over.
Yeah, that this side is the most over here vulnerable because it's just right here. So you just don't want the wind to rip it off. But we're just about done. So Savannah just added this board down here to just secure everything down there.
All right, let's do a teeny tiny tour. This we put up so we could hang the water on, and just about to fill it up. Are you excited to get them in here now?
Yes.
Come on. This is your new home. For you guys.
What are you doing?
Painting our sign. Savannah drew it, and she's leaving me to paint it, which is risky, but here we are. We are very happy to be done with our coop. The chicks are very happy to be in the coop. They have a lot more space to run around and eat and play, and they've been roosting quite a bit. Savannah's flying a drone over my head as we speak. If you have any questions, like why we chose this style of coop, because there are several different chicken tractor ideas, or have any questions about the design, please leave us a comment below. We're talking about doing a video about the different components of this coop and why we chose this over other styles. And as always, give us a thumbs up if you like this video, subscribe, all that fun stuff. Thanks for watching. Have a great week. Bye. My dear, life won't